Morning, ladies and gents. I've just come on very quickly to share this box with you. This was the prototype I made, the sample, and it just looks like an ordinary box, but you open it up and it splits into two. Now, I have done ones where I've done four shelves, but this is just a quick, simple, easy two-step one. So I'll give you the dimensions. Okay, so the lid, you're going to need a piece of card that measures 6 1/8 by 6 1/8, and you're going to score 1.5 all the way around. Your DSP, you're going to need one piece that's cut at 2 3/4 by 2 3/4, and then you're going to need four pieces that are cut at 1 1/4 by 2 3/4. Okay, so that's your lid. And I've already gone along and done all my scoring. So I'll put that over there. And I'm just going to burnish my score lines. Hardly got any voice this morning. A lot of crying and a lot of celebrating went on yesterday. Okay, so I've finished all my score lines. Now what you're going to do is just bring these side pieces in and stick them, okay, to form our lid. So I'm just going to put some glue on these. And I would say, wherever possible, when making a box, use wet glue if it'll work. Most of it on that one. Just take some off that side, it's way too much. Okay, so, and then just build your sides up, making sure they line up perfectly. And as you would have noticed, I done a little notch out on mine, just so that there was no overhang at the top. And I'm sorry, I've had to put the, you can't even see what I'm doing. I've had to put the light on because it's very windy here. I'm sure you can hear it. And it's also very dark. So just make sure you line up them corners. And it's chucking it down. So then I can put our DSP on, and this is 2 3/4 by 2 3/4. I'm just giving that just a little border. Okay, and then round your sides. And if you have pattern paper like me, make sure you have your pattern going the right way. And again, this will just leave you a little border all the way round. Okay. This is supposed to be Storm Doris or something. Well, she doesn't seem very happy. Look, I've moved that one. Oh, come on. No, I'm not going to be able to move it back. Never mind, just ignore it. So we're just going on with all our DSP on our panels. Trying to get them straight and keeping them straight. Okay. I'm just after lighting the fire for the dogs. The old fella, my Westie, Ollie. He loves the fire once it's lit. You can't get him away from it. Little heat bug ears. Right, so we leave that to dry and then we're going to do our side. Now for the side, you're going to need a piece of card that measures 3 by 12 inches. And you're going to score it at 3, 6 and 9. Okay, and your DSP panels are going to be 2¾ by 2¾, and again mine are patterned, so make sure you pay attention to which way your pattern's going to go up, and you're going to need 4 of these panels. Okay, and again they are 2¾ by 2¾. Your base card for the side is 3 by 12, scored 3, 6 and 9. And again, it's just going to give you that little border, that pop of red. Hope everyone's all right. Everyone seems to have been very quiet since Christmas. Just give that a squash. Come on, glue. There we go, getting there. It's better to put these panels on, put your DSP on, before you burnish them score lines. As I'm sure you all know. Could squash down. I can go along that later with my eraser. So I'm going to leave that to dry now and we're going to do the draw pieces. Okay, and for your drawers, well, your little compartments, you're going to need two pieces cut a 5 7/8 by 5 7/8, and you're going to score 1.5 inches on all four sides, all the way around 1.5 inches. Okay, your DSP, you're going to need 4 cut a 2 3/4 by 2 3/4, and you're going to need 4 pieces. Yep. And then you're going to need 4 cut at 1 1/4 by 2 3/4. Okay. But firstly, I'm going to burnish these score lines, and I'm going to make my box up. So you're just going to take it, burnish all them score lines. And then we're going to do the same again, these two tabs. I'm going to put glue on them and stick them to the sides. That's if the glue will play. And you're going to do this to both of them. And again, making sure you line up them perfect, your corners. I've got my new camera up. I shouldn't have got it till my birthday actually, but he gave me it early. This, believe it or not, is the third camera since before Christmas, because the one he bought before Christmas, let me tell you, see the autofocus on it, and it was one of them all singing, all dancing. It was too high tech for me. So then I bought one off Amazon. Just a cheap one, camcorder. I think it cost 50 quid on Amazon. My grandson's got it. Because the battery life on it was awful. Picture quality was awful. But for a child of 4, I thought, well, he may as well use it. Okay, so there's one of our boxes. I won't decorate them just yet. And we're going to do exactly the same to this one. So again, I'm going to pull in these two sides, little side tabs, and I'm going to put some glue on them. See, this glue takes notions with me. Making sure your corners are squared and gluing that down. So this is trial and error with this camera, so if you think there's anything off about it, please let me know. It tickles me the way they give these storms these names. Just go around, make sure it's stuck. Okay, now we'll start putting our DSP on. Now I've chose on the bottom and on the inside of my boxes, I'm going to use the reverse side of that one. just to give it a bit of contrast. I think we have enough red in the box going on. So just on the inside and the underneath. You don't have to do the underneath, you don't have to do the inside, but mine is going as a gift. Oh, come on. This definitely doesn't want to play. Either that or my hands are banjaxed. Turn it over. And as I say, you don't have to do this part. But I'm giving it as a gift. So if I can get the glue to work, I might have to use some contraband. Looks like I'm gonna have to. Let's see. Yeah, this one's open. I'll have to use contraband. You didn't realise, because then you squeeze this one out too fast. So just stick that in there. This isn't grabbing as quick as the Tombow, but at least it's doing its job. Sorry if that was my head in the camera then. I'm going to have to try and... Let me see. I See, I want it to grab quick. What is up with this? I think I've got a dicky batch. See that, the way that's come out. Oh dear. Oh, it could only happen to me on my videos, couldn't it? Got it all over me. Just have to use this sparingly, so it grabs a bit quicker maybe. So you're only going to put your DSP on two sides of these boxes, which is this side and this side for this one, because you're gonna put that on there and they're both gonna be covered up. Okay, so just bear that in mind. That's why you've only got four pieces. Right, I'm gonna get this other one done and then we can put it all together and give it a bit of decoration. And it doesn't matter what way this DSP on these boxes go, because it's just like hot confetti. Can you see that? So it doesn't really matter. Okay, and we'll put the one on the inside. Oh, done it the wrong way. Oh, it doesn't matter. It'll blend anyway. I meant to put it in on the red side. But it'll go with. Now again, let me just see. So we want this side. Side. Okay, so on this side with you not no DSP on, just put some glue. And on the other side with no DSP on. Okay, and now what we're going to do is we're going to line this up with the bottom of our card, our base card, and it would help if I'd scored the lines, wouldn't it? Brains, dangerous. So I'm just going to take my going folder and just going to give that a squash down. Because I need it to be touching the bottom. Okay, and then what you're going to do is you're going to bring your other side round to meet up with that. All the time, making sure that that's touching the base. So I'm just holding it for a little minute while it takes a grip. Okay, so that's our first one on. So your next one, what you're going to do is you're going to stick it up the top. Okay, and again, that's my lid. We're going to do it on the sides that have got no DSP on. I'm just putting some glue on. I do apologise if I am keep going out of frame. But with my other camera, I was working more towards me. This is working away from me, I don't know. Okay, so we're going to stick this one at the top this time. Making sure that your other glued side is here. And I just want to make sure that that's straight on me. On my lid. Oops, nearly wasn't. I glue it to the table and everything. And I'll just give that a little burnish. Then we're going to flip that over and line it up again with this one. And give it a burnish, make sure that glue sticks. Okay, so that's what you should be looking at so far. Okay, I'll just give that a little minute just to grab properly. Okay, so then what you're going to do is fold that round. Okay, so that's what we had. One at the top, one at the bottom. You fold it round. And then you put your lid on. Mine's warped now because of that, all that glue. It does go on, honestly, it does. Just don't put as much glue on as I have. There you go. There we go. Okay. So when it comes off, the person receiving it will open it. And I have some tissue paper. I'm just gonna rip it down the middle and I'm going to put that in there. As I said, this is for a gift for my daughter. Because I think she deserves it. And I just bought her this bracelet for Valentine's Day. So I'm going to put that in there on the tissue paper. It did come in a box, but the box wasn't that very pretty, to be honest with you. roll a bit of tissue paper. No particular reason for this tissue paper, just to stop if stuff from rolling about in it, that's all. And my daughter loves love hearts, so I've got these little packs of love hearts, and I'm going to put them in. Okay, and now we'll put on our lid, she says again. There we go, put on our lid, and I've got a tag, and I'm just going to get me bitty flower punch. And I've got some red in my card, well, Whisper White and Real Red. Punch a couple of them out. Punch a couple of them out. Where's my little? Hobby was in putting the camera in last night and he's moved everything on me. So I'm just going to give these a bit of life. And again with this one. And I'm just using a ball tool. And again with this one. And my daughter does deserve a little treat, so after everything that's gone on, so I thought that nice gold bracelet. I've had some pills cut out. See, when you're trying to rush for a video, see, in future I'm not going to be think I'm doing it, I'm just going to think as though I'm crafting. Not going to even think about the camera. Okay, and we'll use some glue dots just to put them on. So we'll just put the white one in the corner. These mini glue dots are fantastic. I'm going to do a red one up there. Do a red one over here. In between them, I'm just going to stick a couple of random pearls. And I'm going to stick that tag on as well. And this was out of the, oh, what were them tags called? Lots of tags or something. So there we go, there's the lid of our box. We can, it's probably glued on now. Take the lid off. She sees that she's got some love hearts, opens it up, and there's her bracelet. So I'll give you them measurements again for everything. So for the lid, it's 6 1/8 by 6 1/8. Score on all four sides at 1.5 For the DSP, you're going to need one piece at 2¾ by 2¾, and then four pieces at 1¼ by 2¾. Okay, for your side, you're going to need a piece of card. As you see, I've used real red. That still hasn't stuck properly. And it's going to be 3 by 12 inches, and you're going to score it at 3, 6 and 9. You're going to need four pieces of DSP that measure 2¾ by 2¾. You're also going to need your side panels, which is these, which measure 1¾ by 2¾. Okay, so that's your sides. Then for your inside boxes, which is these, you're going to need to make two, and you're going to need to cut two pieces at 5⅞ by 5⅞. Now you're going to need two. You're going to score them both on all four sides at 1½ inches. Then you're going to cut down your tabs and notch in a little bit. And your DSP for them, for your boxes, is 1¼ by 2¾, which is this one here, and 2¾ by 2¾ for the inside ones. So I hope you give that a go, and let me see what you can come up with. And I shall speak to you all soon. I'm not going to put away, I'm going to put it back on. I'll speak to you all soon, so take care. Bye.